one of the signs that we had a conversation, and oftentimes people will look at, you know, this as being a sign or that being a sign. Something really cool happened as a validation of not forgetting who James is, and that happened with his music.
Oh my God.
It's such a cool story. Can you share that?
This was only probably, I'd say this was June, I'll never forget, it was around my birthday. And my son played acoustics guitar, which is one of my favorite instruments. He picked it up in high school. And just one day he just picked it up, and the fella who taught him the strings, because he just picked it up and he said, "You know what, Jamesy, you're a natural." And he said, "I am?" He said, "Yeah." And so James just started playing, and I said to him, "You know what, Jamesy, I want to take that music. I want you to go to a studio. You have to go to a studio and you have to record your music." And he's like, "Oh, Mom, who's going to want to listen to my music, you know?" And I said, "Me. I want to listen to your music." That was June of 09, and October 4th of 09 is when my son passed. And so I took this and I made it, you know, I was telling you the busy part of myself. I took that and I decided to make it a professional CD. And so when I developed and I made this CD, I sell it now, and all the monies from that goes to the James Ghiringhelli Memorial Fund Strings of Life because of the guitar, and it brings life to those who are going to receive the scholarship. The first one was already given out. All of the kids, one by one, came out on that stage at the Newfield High School. This one kid, Chris, he came all the way off the stage and he came over to me. He's only 17. And he said, "Miss Ghiringhelli, I couldn't even imagine what it's like to lose a child. I'm close to my mom, and I just want to let you know that my heart is with you." And he went back on the stage, and I said, "Thank you, James." He was the only one, and he was the one that I chose.
Wasn't there like an award that was won, or he was nominated or something?
Oh, he was on radio. James was on radio. You know, I do radio, did radio on WMJC, and they have this unlabeled show, and they had thousands and thousands of people that put in for this, and you know, I put Jamesy's music in and they listened to it, and of course they said, you know, they called me up and they said, you know, "We feel that his music, we want to put it on, and we chose out of all the songs The Last Goodbye." I named his CD. Jamesy had no song titles. So all the song titles, and I feel I need to explain that because people don't understand, why is it The Last Goodbye? What does that mean? And I named it The Last Goodbye because he was saying goodbye to his girlfriend, and it is his last goodbye because he's no longer here. So, you know, all the songs were labeled in that way as a tribute.
Josephine, thank you so much.
Thank you
so much for doing this. I appreciate it.
Thank you.